Hi dear students, welcome to the third session of Democratic Politics of class 9th CBSE. In our last two classes already we have discussed the election process of Haryana and democracy without election, as well as the merits and demerits of political competitions. Today we are going to deal the next topic, what is our system of election. Through this part, let's discuss how elections are held in India. I told you earlier that we have elections in India after every 5 years to Lok Sabha, to state legislative assemblies, as well as the local self-government bodies. Local self-government bodies means the government of panchayat, block panchayat, jilla panchayat, as well as corporations and municipalities. Elections of Lok Sabha are held at a time all over the country within a few days period. But elections to state legislative assembly are held in different time, depends upon the completion of 5 years tenure in each state or other political changes. Remember, elections held for all the constituencies at the same time is called general election. Elections held at a time for all the constituencies of the country is called general election. It can be a Lok Sabha election or it can be a state legislative assembly election. Elections held only for one constituency to fill the vacancy of a candidate caused by death or resignation of a member is called by-election. So here you have to remember differentiation between general election and by-election. General election means elections held for all the constituencies at a time. By-election means an election conducted only for a constituency due to the vacancy of a candidate due to death or resignation. Now let's move to the next part, that is, what is electoral constituencies? Dear students, I hope you know that all the MPs of India are not elected by all the people of the country, as well as all the MLAs of a particular state are not elected by all the people of that state. We have a system for that. Our country is divided into different areas for the purpose of elections. These areas are called electoral constituencies. Our country is divided into different areas for the purpose of elections. So these areas are called electoral constituencies. The voters who live in a Lok Sabha constituency elect an MP from that constituency, while the voters who live in a state legislative constituency elect an MLA from that constituency. So remember, Lok Sabha constituencies are different from the state legislative assembly constituency. Lok Sabha constituencies are larger than the assembly constituencies. For example, for Lok Sabha elections, our country is divided into 543 constituencies. That means our whole country is divided into 543 areas for the purpose of elections. So we have in Karnataka 28 such Lok Sabha constituencies. That means whole Karnataka is divided into 28 areas for the Lok Sabha election. So only 28 MPs, member of parliaments, can be selected from Karnataka. A constituency is made almost equal population and favorable geographical area. Similarly, a state is also divided into assembly constituencies. For example, Karnataka is divided into 224 assembly constituencies. A parliamentary constituency includes many assembly constituencies. For example, Haveri Lok Sabha constituency of Karnataka comprises 8 assembly constituencies. Haveri Lok Sabha constituency of Karnataka comprises or includes 8 assembly constituencies such as Shirati, Gadag, Hangal, Haveri, Byadagi, Hirakkerur, Ranabennur and Ron. So the same principle is applied for panchayat election as well as municipality elections. Each village or town is divided into several wards like small constituencies, and each ward member is selected from each constituency, small constituency. It is also known as seats. So we understood that what is constituency. A constituency is nothing but an area fixed for an election in which a particular candidate is elected. Dear students, now let's move to the next part of the electoral politics, that is reserved constituencies. Just before we understood what is a constituency, now let's understand what is a reserved constituency. Our constitution gives right to every citizen after 18 years to elect a representative, as well as after 25 years to be elected as a representative. That means after became 18 years, you can do vote. After crossing 25 years old, you can contest in the election. But our constitution makers were worried that every weaker section or minority people or unprivileged groups of the country may not get chance to contest in the election due to the pressure or the power of the privileged groups or socially, economically, politically forward groups. If it happens so, what will happen? Our parliament will not have the voice of the minority people or weaker sections. So they have introduced reserved constituencies for the weaker sections. So remember what is reserved constituencies. They are the constituencies reserved for the socially or economically or religiously backward groups. That means only a person who belongs to such a kind of a community can be elected as a representative from any political party in a particular constituency. In India, we have 84 reserved constituencies for scheduled caste, that is SC. 84 reserved constituencies, while we have 47 reserved constituencies for STs, scheduled tribes. That means total 131 seats of 543 parliamentary constituency are reserved for only SC and STs. That means only a person who belongs to these minority groups is eligible to contest as a candidate. So this system is followed even in state legislative constituencies also. It is also followed in local self-government bodies. That means even state legislative assembly election also, few seats in every state are reserved for this SC and ST or other minority groups. Local bodies are now reserved for even OBCs also, other backward caste, in local self-government bodies. And there are 1/3 reservation for women in local self-government body elections. That means election for the panchayat or municipality or corporation, we have reserved 1/3 seats for women. Some states like Karnataka, Kerala have reserved even 50% of the seats for women. So this is known as reservation in constituencies. Now let's understand what is meant by nomination of candidates. You know, any voter can become a candidate and contest in the election after reaching 25 years of age. So to contest in an election, minimum 25 years of age is required. So each party nominate or suggest a candidate for every election. This party nomination is called party ticket. So understand, nomination is nothing but a candidate who is suggested by a particular political party is called party nomination or party ticket. So in newspaper you might have heard that is this person got party ticket or this person rejected a party ticket. So party ticket is nothing but party nomination or party suggestion or support to contest in a particular election. A candidate has to fill a nomination form and give some money as security deposit to contest in an election in India. So nomination form is a form that includes all the whereabouts of the person, and he has to pay 25,000 rupees as a security deposit to contest in a Lok Sabha election, as well as 10,000 rupees to contest in a state legislative assembly election. So it's a security deposit. If a person get a percentage of what, he will get back that amount what he has paid. This is introduced just to avoid the unnecessary entry of the candidates. Every candidate should give a legal declaration to the Election Commission of India before every election, declaring criminal cases pending, details of assets and liabilities of his as well as his family, education qualification, etc. This is called affidavit in election procedure. So remember, affidavit is an official legal declaration submitted by every candidate to the Election Commission stating his or her criminal cases pending, the details of assets and liabilities of his or her as well as family with educational qualification. Next, let us understand what is voters list. Voters list. Remember, the list that includes the names of all the eligible voters of a constituency is called voters list. This voters list is also known as electoral roll. It is produced by the Election Commission. So understand what is voters list. It is a list produced by the government which includes the names and photos and address of all the eligible voters of all the constituencies. This is very important for a democratic election because this list is made on an equal basis of universal adult franchise without any discrimination. Each person who are aged 18 years and above are eligible to do vote. So as you have already learned, universal adult franchise, so regardless of caste, religion or gender, every adult is given right to vote. Before every election, the voters list is renewed and made up to date. New adults are added in the voters list, and people who died or people who transferred to other constituencies are deleted from the voters list. So briefly understand what is voters list. It's a list that consists the names and address of all the eligible voters of a particular constituency. Before every election, it is renewed. In the last few years, Election Photo Identity Card, EPIC, is introduced in our country. So you might have seen your parents' election a photo identity card. So there is an identity card used to do vote in a particular election, as well as it is considered as an ID proof of a person for other purposes also. Dear children, today we understood 4 to 5 important topics of electoral politics. Read the particular part of the chapter in detail, and if you have any doubts, please contact me. Few assignment questions will be sent along with that. Try to solve that, and if you have any confusion regarding any of the factors, please contact me.